the velocity. Okay, so basically this velocity is basically what it is, it is the speed plus direction. Velocity is speed plus direction. Okay, so if I say that a car is moving with the speed of say like 60 km/h, so this is the speed of the car. But if I say that this is moving with the speed of 60 km/h in the northward direction, then it becomes the velocity of the car, because we have also mentioned the direction also with the car. Mathematically, velocity is defined as the ratio of displacement and the time. Velocity is equal to displacement divided by time interval. Okay, so basically this, because displacement is a vector quantity, so we say that velocity is also a vector quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. So one very big difference between speed and velocity is that speed is a scalar quantity and the velocity is a vector quantity. Okay, now as we have studied about velocity, so now we'll study about different types of velocities. Okay, so the first thing that we are going to study about this is uniform velocity, a very important concept of uniform velocity. Now what is uniform velocity? If we go by definition, because we have said that velocity is defined as, we have said that velocity is defined as the ratio of displacement divided by the time interval. So we say that if a body covers equal displacement, if the body is having equal displacement in equal interval of time, then the body is said to have a uniform velocity. This is the mathematical definition of uniform velocity. But if we try to understand basically what is uniform velocity, because we have said that velocity is defined as speed plus direction. So if an object is moving and its speed as well as the direction of motion, both of them remain constant, both of them does not change with time, then it is said to be moving with uniform velocity. So if a man is walking on the road with the speed of 5 km/h, okay, there is a man who is walking on the road with the speed of 5 km/h and he is walking straight without changing its direction, then he is said to be moving with uniform velocity. If there is a change in speed, then the velocity cannot remain uniform. And if the direction changes, then also the velocity cannot remain uniform. So uniform velocity means the speed as well as direction remains same. And by definition wise, we say that uniform velocity is, if a particle covers equal displacement in equal interval of time, then it is said to be moving with uniform velocity. Now after this uniform velocity, we have another concept of non-uniform velocity related to this. So this is also very simple definition of uniform, non-uniform velocity. If the particle is going through unequal displacement in equal interval of time, unequal displacement in equal interval of time, or equal displacement in unequal interval of time, then it is said to be moving with non-uniform velocity. So if suppose there is a man who is walking and he covers unequal displacement in every second, sometimes he goes through 2 meter, sometimes 1 meter, sometimes 1/2 meter, so this is unequal displacement in equal interval of time, means every second, then he is moving with non-uniform velocity. or he's having equal displacements in unequal interval of time. So if I'm walking, I'm going through 1 meter, sometimes in 2 seconds, sometimes in 3 seconds, sometimes in 2.5 seconds. So this is unequal time interval. Then also I'm having a non-uniform velocity, okay? Let us now discuss the concept of average velocity. So average velocity is defined as the total displacement upon total time of the journey. That is called average velocity. The concept is very similar to the concept of average speed. We have defined average speed as the total distance traveled divided by total time taken. Now, if I compare these two concepts, now I know that the displacement is always less than or equal to distance. We already know this because when the particle is moving in a straight line without turning back, then only the displacement is equal to distance. Otherwise, displacement is always less than distance. So the magnitude of the average velocity is always less than or equal to the average speed. The magnitude means the value of the average velocity will always be less than or equal to average speed because displacement is less than or equal to distance. Sometimes they may ask you a question like this, that what is the condition for average velocity to be equal to average speed? The condition is that the particle or the object should move in a straight line without turning back, because in that situation only the displacement will be equal to distance, so the average velocity will be equal to the average speed in that case. Okay.